Would you recommend your relationship to someone you love? Do you blame your boss or your workplace for feeling stressed? I'm Soufiane, and I'm a certified cognitive behavioral therapy practitioner. If you're in a toxic relationship, well, chances are you wouldn't even know about it because you've grown to believe that being with someone is all about making efforts, sticking together, and compromising. But as much as you love your partner, it will never shield you from being in a relationship that could make your life a living hell. So, what signs should you be looking out for? A typical relationship pattern that's quite detrimental is one where a partner is self-centered, who believes that every one of their expectations and needs must be met. And whenever you deviate from those expectations, that is, if you don't reply to their texts on time, show them the level of attention they require, conform to their demand, if you so much dare to give them any feedback about their misbehaviors you dislike, and much more, then they feel entitled to becoming angry, hostile, defensive, and engage in a number of behaviors that shouldn't be acceptable. They will make you feel inadequate or insecure. They will leverage guilt to have you change as they adopt verbally abusive tactics that boil down to demeaning you as a person, hold the relationship hostage by making threats to end it, blaming you or accusing you by using totalizing language, such as you never or you always do that, discounting your efforts in the process, and even make assumptions about your intentions towards them. So, naturally, if the other is scared of triggering those reactions, if they try to keep the peace and their relationship smooth because they're afraid of conflict, they may comply with the other's expectations so as to not make them angry because they feel good about themselves only on the condition that the other shows them affection or validation. But it's simply not viable. And it's tricky because you may believe that you're being nice or gentle for keeping the peace, but in reality, you're just harmless and unable to set healthy boundaries and can't manage conflict where others become disagreeable. And even if you did try, you would probably notice that the other is unlikely to take any accountability for their misbehaviors. Which is why a question I ask in my sessions to people with relationship problems is, would you recommend your relationship to someone you love? And if the answer is no, then why would you keep it to yourself? Here's a common misconception that most of us make. We believe that our problems are outside of us. But it's simply not the case. Otherwise, we would all have the same reaction to the same activating event. But clearly, someone else could take with a smile whatever is weighing on you at the moment. So, if you admit that your circumstances are not the problem in and of themselves, you understand that your feelings are the cause of your discomfort. Because it's not so much your work per se that is a problem, it's the stress that it triggers inside of you that is. It's not so much anyone else's behaviors that are a problem, it's the frustration you feel towards those behaviors. And if you're not one to check in with yourself, you will end up nurturing a lot of emotional junk that will hinder your well-being and your health in the long run, while believing that what happens to you is to blame for your discomfort. But in fact, your negative emotions act like messengers. They're saying that something is wrong either in your perception of your situation or in your reaction to it. You may complain that you're stressed out at work, but the reality is you can't bring yourself to negotiate with your boss for better deadlines because you're scared and lack assertiveness. You may be dissatisfied in your relationships, but most of the time you close yourself off to healthy communication because you don't know how to properly express your anger. But if you're complaining about a situation without offering any solutions, in reality you're whining. Because it's much easier to play the victim rather than admitting that the outcome you're experiencing at the moment is the result of an internal problem that can be broken down into how you think, how you feel, how you behave or react, which incidentally may point at the skills that you're lacking that could help you properly deal with your reality, or at the internalized perceptions or beliefs you need to uncover in order to see things for what they are. Becoming mindful of your own shortcomings isn't an overnight process. It requires asking yourself the right questions to become aware of what is going inside of you. But that could be achieved through a deep self-reflection that we can work on together. So sign up on Amphy to learn more about it.